It's recording now.
Yeah.
Okay. You gotta help me walk over there.
Okay.
Hold my hand or... Hold my hand. Are there more cars coming?
No car.
Let me walk towards the edge of the thing.
Can you
get on this side? Am I touching the windows or?
Yeah, walk into the... Almost 5 feet.
Make a right?
Yeah.
Anybody walking out?
To the right.
Okay. Push in or out?
Pull.
Okay. I'm working.
Oh. Can we ask him for permission first?
No. Wait for that.
Coffee stand is on the right. Coffee station on the right.
Put my hand where the cups are. They're large. Are these the small ones? This is the small one, right?
Right.
And where's the coffee?
Mm-hmm.
Where do I put my hand to push it? Is it pulling in?
Yeah.
Is it almost full?
No.
Is that enough?
A little more?
That's
okay.
Enough. Okay, now take me to the creamer. Put it here? Where's the creamer? I need vanilla. These are the vanilla creamers?
To the left?
The left?
No.
Here?
No.
Move my hand to the creamer.
The cup is here?
Yeah.
Creamer.
This is the vanilla creamer?
Yes. Vanilla. That's vanilla. Is four tubs?
Yeah, that's
four tubs enough?
Yeah.
All right. Now throw that in the trash?
Yeah.
Not yet? Right here.
Where's the lid and the... happens. What is this? Kim, what's this?
For your cup, it is hot.
There's nothing. Oh, those little...
Ready to pay?
Yeah.
Do you have your wallet?
Into?
No, no people. All right, walk to the right. Stop right there. Stop. Don't walk. Now walk to the right. Mm-hmm. Pull your coffee.
Yeah.
About 20 feet to the left is the register. Treat him as if he's a blind person.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Have a good day.
Thank you. You got your coffee?
Yeah.
All right. Now, walk to the left is the door. Do you want to put your wallet in your pocket first?
Okay.
All right. Now, the door is right there. All right. Stay right there. Okay, keep walking down to the car. Now turn around to the front of the car on the passenger side. All right, stay right here. Let me unlock. Alright, feel the cars on your right. You buckle up. Rodrigo, can you discuss the kinds of training you would need to successfully adapt to this disability?
Yes, if I was visually impaired and I wasn't able to see, I think I would need to get training from a visual impairment specialist so they can teach me like how to read Braille. I would have to get Braille literacy skills. I would also need to get social skills because there's a lot of things that I wasn't aware of about somebody who was visually impaired in regards to their ability to do or read social cues. Because while I was blind, I couldn't really understand things that I thought I knew how to do. I didn't feel confident walking around having to depend with someone to guide me. So I need to become more assertive with my issues in regards to moving around. I need to be more confident with my body posture because I looked at the videos and I noticed that I seemed timid and I was slouching and I don't think I was giving people eye contact because most of the time I wanted to keep my head down. I would need to learn how to use a cane when I walk because walking out in the public, I noticed that I stumbled a few times on the sidewalk. I need to be able to take like mobility skills classes or learn somehow how to move around in the house, in the community. I would want to learn how to use some of the auditory tools and the tactile tools. I think that would make my life a little more convenient and I would be able to communicate using those tools either by having things read and translated into Braille or things scanned and then I could hear it through the computer.
Okay, and number two question is that were there any environmental hazards or accessibility problems, such as lack of wheelchair ramps, insufficient room to navigate a wheelchair?
There were some hazards, I think, but those were mostly when I was out in the community. Here in the house, I did bump into things, especially in the garage, because there's so much stuff laying around. In the house, not as much, but I could see how that could also be a problem if there's a lot of clutter. But out in the community, even pouring a cup of coffee could be hazardous because of the temperature of the coffee. I was afraid of getting burned. Walking through a parking lot, that's a hazard if there's cars in the parking lot. I'm glad you were holding my hand and guiding me through there.
Okay, I have another question. How might you need to adapt your home environment to live independently with this disability?
I think I would get rid of the stools that I have in the living room area. I would not leave things on the ground, like shoes or slippers. I would definitely would have to add something, especially in the door between the garage, from the kitchen to the garage, because it's a big step down and a big step up. I would remove things in the garage that were dangerous, I guess, if I were to step on it or if it would hit me. And I would need help in regards to designing better where we keep some of the pots, the pans.